Very good morning, class. So as you all know, we have already started with RSP lesson number 7, that is correspondence with debenture holders. Class, we'll be completing the chapter today because we have already finished 3 specimen letters, and today we'll be targeting the 4th and the final one. So with this, our 2 lessons on correspondence we have already finished. So we will finish 2 of the lessons related to letters. So in all, adding these 4 and the last chapters, 4 letters. So total 8 topics of letter writing we have finished. So moving forward, these were the letters which we have already covered. These are the first 3. That is informing the participant about the allotment of debentures, their payment of interest by sending interest warrant, and electronic payment of interest. Then yesterday we saw letter related to conversion of debentures into equity shares. Today we'll be focusing on the last and the final one, that is redemption of debentures. So this redemption word we have already covered many a times in the previous chapters as well. So the usual way, before we move on to the exact letter, let us revise some of the questions related to it. So your very first question is, what do you mean by redemption? How is the redemption of debentures done by the company? How are the debenture holders informed by the company about the redemption of debentures? So any of y'all got the answers for the following questions? If not, then pay attention. So the very first question was, what do you mean by redemption? Redemption in simple words means repayment, paying back. So repaying back the money of the debenture holders to them is called as redemption. Redeem word you all must have heard, like for example, on online payments, or you buy a particular offer like from Amazon or something. They tell you 10% cash back, or you can redeem the coupon in your next purchase. So all these are the types of examples of redemption. So that is repaying back the money to the holders. It is clearing of debt by the company. So debenture is a kind of a borrowed loan, was an example of borrowed loan. So redemption of debentures means the company is clearing its debt or loan that it had taken from the debenture holders. Okay. Next is, how is the redemption of debentures done by the company? So for this, the company creates DRRF account. So class, we have already done this topic when I was teaching you all lesson number 4, issue of debentures. Anyone knows the full form DRR account? Correct. It is debenture redemption reserve fund account. So it is an account which is created separately by the company, from which the redemption, the repaying back or clearing the debt of the company is being done. How are the debenture holders informed by the company about the redemption? So for this, they send letter of redemption that we'll be studying just now, along with the debenture redemption form, which has to be filled by the debenture holders. So, are you all clear, class, what we are going to study in this particular letter? Okay. So, moving forward towards the 4th topic, redemption of debentures. Letter of redemption of debenture is issued to the debenture holders whose debentures are to be redeemed after a specific period. So, in the 4th lesson, we have already studied maximum 10 years ka time rehta hai. And those who are granted special permission by central government or state government or RBI, those companies can redeem back the debentures after a period of more than 10 years, but it cannot exceed 30 years. That we have already covered in the 4th chapter. A DRRF account is created, that is redemption reserve fund is created by the company for the purpose of redemption of debentures. A debenture redemption form is also sent with this letter. This informs this form and all the necessary documents have to be submitted by the debenture holders to the company for further procedure of redemption. This letter informs the debenture holders that their debentures are due for redemption. So in this way, the company informs the debenture holders about their repayment thing. This is how the letter looks. So here is an example of Swastik Marble Limited Company. So the registered address is given along with the CIN. On the left hand side, you can see the phone number, the fax number, the website and the email address. Reference Swastik Marble Limited. So S/DH means debenture holders. Serial number 13, year 19 to 20. Date is 10th October 2019. Mrs. Asmita Malpani. So subject is redemption of debentures. Dear madam, this is to inform you that 1,10,000 non-convertible debentures issued in May 2014 are due for redemption on 12th November 2019. According to the board resolution number 3462 passed at the board meeting held on 8th of October 2019, the debentures shall be redeemed out of DRRF of the company. So in this introductory paragraph, what the secretary is writing that the 1,10,000 non-convertible debentures which Mrs. Asmita Malpani has invested in May 2014 are going to be due on 12th of November 2019. So according to the board resolution which was passed in the board meeting, which was held on 8th October, the debentures shall be redeemed out of the DRRF fund. So it is clearly stated that the redemption, the repayment is done from the debenture redemption reserve fund. Please arrange to submit the enclosed debenture redemption form along with the original debenture certificate to the company. So for the repayment purpose, they have to fill a form which is called as debenture redemption form and also submit the original debenture certificate which was issued by the company to her on or before 3rd of November 2019. On completion of the above formalities, the redemption amount will be credited to your bank account. So once the formalities are done, the documents are verified and checked, the said debenture redemption amount will be credited in her bank account. You are requested to provide us your bank account details. Thanking you, yours faithfully, for Swastik Marble Limited, signed by the company secretary, Mrs. Usha Surti, and enclosure debenture redemption form. So basically, this is how the letter is written, that for that purpose, some formalities are to be completed. So she has to submit the debenture redemption form, fill the details and attach it with the original debenture certificate, which was issued by the company, and send them back to the company when the formalities are done till 3rd November. So when the formalities will be done, the amount will be credited in her account. And for that, she has to share her bank account details. So this is how the letter should be written, and I hope the letter is really simple to understand. So with this class, we'll have a quick brush up of what all letters we studied. As you all know, informing the participant about allotment of debentures, then payment of interest by issuing interest warrant and electronic payment wala. Then we saw yesterday conversion of debentures into equity shares. And today we saw the letter related to redemption of debentures. So with this class, we are done with the topic. Okay. If any doubt, you can let me know. And please practice these letters 2 to 3 times. And again, I hope if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel. Tell your other friends also to do the same. And if you feel that someone else also can benefit from this particular video, you can please share the link to them. All right, class. So till then, take care, stay safe, keep learning, keep studying, and any doubt, please let me know. All right, so we stop here for today. Thank you so much for listening to me. We'll meet again tomorrow with the next session. All right, thank you so much.